The heavens are telling the glory of God, and all creation is shouting for joy. Come dance in the forest, come play in the field, and sing, sing to the glory of the Lord. Sing, sing to the glory.
Gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you. Sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, welcome to this Eucharistic celebration on the 17th Sunday of Ordinary Time. God continues to speak to us. God always listens to us, listens to our prayers. Today, God is calling us to deepen our prayer life. How do we go about praying to God? Persistence, persevere in prayer life. That's one of the gifts of the Holy Spirit, that we may persevere. Sometimes we pray and we give up. But God wants us to be strong in trusting God. And so we pray to God this most holy Eucharist, the highest form of prayer that the church has provided, the church has on earth, that we may deepen our faith and our trust in God through the most holy Eucharist. And so let's acknowledge our sins and pray, I confess. That I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fall, through my fall. All the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison.
Most High Jesus. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory, glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In those days, the Lord said, "The outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah is so great, and their sin so grave, that I must go down and see whether or not their actions fully correspond to the cry against them that comes to me. I mean to find out." While Abraham's visitors walked on farther towards Sodom, the Lord remained standing before Abraham. Then Abraham drew nearer and said, "Will you sweep away the innocent with the guilty? Suppose there were 50 innocent people in the city. Would you wipe out the place rather than spare it for the sake of the 50 innocent people within it? Far be it from you to do such a thing, to make the innocent die with the guilty, so that the innocent and the guilty would be treated alike. Should not the judge of all the world act with justice?" The Lord replied, "If I find 50 innocent people in the city of Sodom, I will spare the whole place for their sake." Abraham spoke up again, "See how I am presuming to speak to my Lord, though I am but dust and ashes. What if there are 5 less than 50 innocent people? Will you destroy the whole city because of those 5? He answered, "I will not destroy it if I find 45 there." But Abraham persisted, saying, "What if only 40 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it for the sake of the 40. Then Abraham said, "Let not my Lord grow impatient if I go on. What if only 30 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it if I can find but 30 there." Still, Abraham went on, "Since I have thus dared to speak to my Lord, what if there are no more than 20? The Lord answered, "I will not destroy it for the sake of the 20. But he still persisted, "Please, let not my Lord grow angry if I speak up this last time. What if there are at least 10 there?" He replied, "For the sake of those 10, I will not destroy it." The word of the Lord.
Amen.
will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple and give thanks to your name. Lord, on the day I called for help, you answered me. Because of your kindness and your truth, for you have made great above all things your name and your promise. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me. Lord, on the day I called for help, you answered me. The Lord is exalted, yet the lowly he sees, and the proud he knows from afar. Though I walk amid distress, you preserve me. Against the anger of my enemies, you raise your hand. Lord, on the day I called for help, you answered me. Your right hand saves me. The Lord will complete what he has done for me. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands. Lord, on the day I called for help, you answered me.
Lectura de la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Colosenses. Hermanos, por el bautismo fueron ustedes sepultados con Cristo y también resucitaron con Él, mediante la fe en el poder de Dios, que lo resucitó de entre los muertos. Ustedes estaban muertos por sus pecados y no pertenecían al pueblo de la alianza, pero Él les dio una vida nueva con Cristo, perdonándoles todos los pecados. Él anuló el documento que nos era contrario, cuyas cláusulas nos condenaban, y lo eliminó clavándolo en la cruz de Cristo. Palabra de Dios.
Have received a spirit of adoption through which we cry, Abba, Father. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus was praying in a certain place. When he had finished, one of the disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples. He said to them, when you pray, say, Father, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread. And forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone in debt to us. And do not subject us to final test. And he said to them, suppose one of you has a friend to whom he goes at midnight and says, Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived at my house from a journey, and I have nothing to offer him. And he says in reply from within, do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children and I are already in bed. I cannot get up to give you anything. I tell you, if he does not get up to give the visitor the loaves because of their friendship, he will get up and give him whatever he needs because of his persistence. And I tell you, ask and you will receive. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and the one who seeks finds, and to the one who knocks the door will be opened. What father among you would hand his son a snake when he asked for a fish? Or hand him a scorpion when he asked for an egg? If you then who are wicked know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? Sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I want to thank you and welcome you all to this Eucharistic celebration. Once again, I always say, it's the 17th Sunday of Ordinary Time, but the scripture reading is always, always extraordinary. That speaks to us in a profound way. God comes to feed us. God comes to take care of us. God comes to fill us with the spirit of love, and gives us purpose and reasons for us to continue to journey with him as pilgrim people. But before I dive into the details about the scripture reading of today, just want to get your attention about the story about Bill, just for the sake of name, okay? Bill was a notorious, mischievous boy in the classroom. The teacher really had a hard time dealing with him. And every time she does something, he will always take her like behind and always very troublesome. So one day she came early to classroom, she started writing. And to her surprise, Bill was also early. And he saw her, "Hi teacher, what are you doing?" She said, "I'm writing prayers." And then he came, looked at her. She was writing shorthand, right? "I think that shorthand, do you think God understands shorthand?" And the teacher said, "Of course he understands everything perfectly. He knows everything in your heart. He listens to you always." And she started writing. He went back to his bench, and then something came up. The teacher left a letter over there on the table. She went out or something. Guess what Bill did? He grabbed that letter and put it in his book, and he forgot about it. After 30, 40 years, when he himself became a very successful man, he remembered that. Went back to his old books and stuff. He found that letter. Still shorthand, he could not read it. So he rushed to his office and told the girls, "Can you read this for me?" And so they read it. "Lord God, it is a beautiful day. I want to thank you. But my student Bill is so troublesome. Every single day he tests my patience, and I cannot focus my class. You could be very good, you could be very evil. But Lord God, I offer everything to you. Give me the grace and give him the strength to get better. Amen." When Bill heard it, he was crying. And he said, the prayer of my teacher was answered. Are you a teacher? Are you a grandparent? Are you a parent? Are you a single parent? You are bombarded with so many ways that your patience is tested, that you almost end up not able to focus what you're supposed to do. What do you do in moments like that? Do you pray? Do you offer it to God? Or lock yourself in the closet, leave me alone, people? How do you react? Today, same situation happened to our father in faith, Abraham. He's talking to God like a friend talking to a friend. I just want to let you know, prayer is not a set of words. So prayer is not simply feelings. Prayer is not like taking Tylenol when you have a headache. Prayer is like a daily conversation, like my little baby making lullaby. Spontaneous, beautiful conversation that you want to have one-to-one every single day, that gives you strength, that gives you hope, that energizes your whole body from head to toe. Prayer is such a beautiful gift that gives us strength every single day for us to talk to God. It is a relationship. That's why our father in faith is pleading to God like a friend talking to God. So next time when you want to pray, or when you are in prayer, do not simply be satisfied, I'm fulfilling my obligation, or I just finished my prayers. No, I just enjoyed my conversation, my personal encounter with my Lord and my Savior and my best friend. Think about that. Sometimes we kind of, you know, programmed people. I know how to say the rosary. I know how to do the divine mercy, but I cannot be quiet in the house of God. I do not know what to do when there is a Eucharist exposition. I'm there. I'm scared about silent, being silent. When you get into the car, music. When you go into your house, music. When you're going for a walk or hiking, you put your all kinds of bombarded noise and we almost lost the sacred silence that allows you to see God and allowing God to see you. That's another form of prayer. But I just wanted to focus on the beautiful gift, life in Christ, beautiful gift of life in prayer. Prayer life is such an important factor that we always have to deepen. Like you say always to your loved ones, I love you, I love you, I love you. Sometimes they catch you. You say you love me, but you don't help me. You said you love me, but you will do this, you will do this, but you never did. Can you show me that you really love me? Just for example, you love Rose Garden and you bought that new orchard plant and then you put it in your backyard. If you love it, what you should do? You should pour water, visit it every day, and take care of it. If you don't do it, do you think you really love? I don't think so. Similarly, I see some young boys and girls over here. On your birthday, you cried to heaven and earth, I want the pet. I want that kitty. Right? You got it. Your parents gave you as a birthday gift, a special gift. Ask yourself, who is taking care of it? You say you love your pet. If you love it, you need to take care of it lovingly. It's a commitment that you do it every day. And you say, I love God. How do you love God? Do you pray every day? Do you have a conversation with your God every single day as a friend? Or are you just like Tylenol? You reach out to the Tylenol box when you have a headache, when you're in trouble. We need to cultivate the culture of prayer within our heart and mind at all times. If you take one message home, this would be it. We are called to cultivate the prayer. And prayer is not like set up prayer. It is like a conversation with a friend to friend from the heart. Not just petitions, not complaints, not just sorrows. It is every single moment conversation. Because we know what St. Paul says, pray as if you have received it. Prayer is trust. Prayer is relationship. Pray as if you have received it. Think about that. How often we have prayed like that. I hope God can give this. I hope God can bless it. We are always doubtful. We are called to be persistent, strong in our prayer every single day when we pray. Let me go back to the gospel reading, my all-time favorite prayer. That's the all-time favorite prayer of every Christian, every Catholic, every First Holy Communion children, or every time you go to confession, or that kind of, you know, you are always asked to pray. Say the Our Father, say the Hail Mary, say Glory Be, say the, you know, act of contrition, or say, you know, all kinds of prayers that always say, but this kind of comes handy. How many of us truly know the beautiful gift of this prayer? How many of us know the meaning of this prayer? Or how much time do you take to complete this prayer? Maybe 30 seconds? 30 seconds? That's it, right? St. Teresa of Avila, do you know how much time she takes to complete that Our Father prayer? At least 48 hours. When she says, Our Father, she goes into ecstasy, into the company of our Father, who art in heaven, and here the gates of heaven opens for her, and she goes into deeper ecstasy. That's how she prays. That's why Jesus is teaching us, call God Abba, Father. So when you pray the Our Father, you watch out. That's a powerful word on earth. Abba, Father. In my interpretation, you know how I would say? When you say Our Father, you know, Our Father. That's why I said prayer is a relationship. It's not like me. No. Prayer is a relationship. God the Father, the Creator, Son Jesus, the Redeemer, and the Holy Spirit, the Sanctifier, and the fourth person who enters into prayer is you and me. So when you pray, you are not alone. You're calling our Father. Can you tell me the next phrase? I always get stuck on that. Who art in heaven? Okay, I love the fact that God is my Father and I'm really blessed to be His Son. But He is in heaven, I'm on earth. What is going on? He's in heaven, I'm on earth. What is going on? Very simple. You are not at home. Our ultimate goal on earth to enter into heaven. And our prayer that we pray every day is a means for us to enter into heaven, to prepare us a treasure in heaven. And so, dear sisters and brothers, there is so much to share today. And I just came back after retreat, so I have a lot of things to say. I'm not going to bombard you with so many things, but I will stop here. How do we pray this beautiful prayer that Jesus taught us? Calling God the Abba Father. Having conversation with God, daily conversation, like a friend to friend, heart to heart conversation. Because it is your prayer life that will reveal to the whole world who you are. You will not be able to face everything through your own energy, without God's grace, without prayer. Remember that beautiful song? Take it to the Lord in prayer. 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 And so pray. Father, we bless and thank you for this day, for the opportunity to love and serve you. Help us, O God, as people we struggle and fail to pray constantly, to pray faithfully. We have a huge struggle and vacuum, O God. Fill our emptiness. Help us, Lord, to deepen our faith and our trust in you, that we might be able to have the personal love relationship through prayer, that we will ask and knock and seek through prayer as your loving children. We ask this through Christ our Lord. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the Holy Spirit and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. This is the Lord of heaven. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. As loving people of God, deepening our faith and our trust in God through prayer, joyfully let us present our needs to our Father.
For the Pilgrim Church on earth, may God help us to readily forgive others and joyfully seek his kingdom. We pray to the Lord. That we may never tire of petitioning the Lord, as well as elected officials, to restore legal protection to children growing in the womb. We pray to the Lord. For those who are far away from the church, especially within our own families, that they may respond to the call of repentance and reconciliation. We pray to the Lord. That travelers and vacationers may be kept safe both in body and spirit, and that their leisure activities may bring them closer to the Lord. We pray to the Lord. That with the Holy Spirit, all people discern a vocation in Christ, whether it be a vocation in marriage, priesthood, religious life, or a vocation in single life. We pray to the Lord. That those who are ill may be strengthened and comforted, and that those who have died, especially Malia Matato, Ramona Phelps, Leonor, and Arnoldo Padilla, may be received into eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Like the disciples, let us ask the Lord to teach us to pray in silence. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, the most sacred mysteries may sanctify your present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless this gift, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, Myron Kada, our Bishop, and all those who are holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotions are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whom we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God, and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of our whole family. Order our days in your peace and command them we be delivered from the eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve these offerings in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with his eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his Almighty Father, giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to you glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with your serene and kindly countenance and accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gift of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offerings of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayers we ask you, Almighty God, command that this gift be borne by the hands of your holy angels to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessings. Remember also your servants whom we remember in this Mass, who have gone before us with a sign of hope and faith and trust. May they rest in sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who those sinners hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, Saint with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through whom you continue to make all good these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Stand at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, together, slowly, meditatively, thoughtfully, mindfully, we're going to pray. If somebody's rushing, catch the hand, slow down. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ Aloha. I have a couple of announcements. If you want to be seated, you're more than welcome to be seated. Harvest Festival. We are happy to announce that our parish will be having its annual Harvest Festival September 16th, 17th, and 18th. Please consider volunteering to chair a booth or work a shift at the festival by emailing Craig and Jennifer Yasin or by calling the parish office. First of all, mark your calendar and then volunteer, please. Here's your chance to win a large cash prize, up to $10,000, and support 2022 Harvest Festival. We are once again holding a raffle to cover the cost of the professionally installed tents for the festival. Tickets will be sold after Mass today. Today, hey, that's good. And at the parish office during the week. Only 500 tickets will be sold at $100 each. $100, not a dollar. Installation Mass. All are welcome to my installation as a pastor. Bishop Kada will be here on August 10th, 5:30 p.m. We will begin with a multilingual rosary just to get a sense of who we are as a community. So we're going to pray in Dutch. We're going to pray in Portuguese. We're going to pray in Tagalog. We're going to pray in Spanish. My mom is going to be here, so I'm going to ask her to pray in my language. So 5:30, and then Mass would be 6 o'clock. And after that, we will have reception in the hall. Last Sunday, Chaplet of the Divine Mercy and Family Rosary, the Knights of Columbus and Legion of Mary invite you, all parish families, to our monthly Chaplet of Divine Mercy and Family Rosary to be held on Sunday, July 31st, 3 p.m. in the church. That's about it. Thank you. Please stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you. Yes. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go in the love of Christ to be merciful like the Heavenly Father.
Thanks be God. The people in darkness.